Good evening, dear students. So today the word of the day is cox. Yesterday we have learnt in a chapter. So the word cox, it means persuade or insist, to force someone. So here we have seen in the relation of the content that Halku has forced or insist Munni to give the money, because Munni was not willing to give the money, but Halku has forced her. And this is cursive B. So see, here also I have written two varieties, so you can write it any other variety. This is of calligraphy. The first B is calligraphy and the second B which we are doing in our school, so you can practice both. Yesterday, day before yesterday, we have learned about A, two types, and today we are learning about B. So now let us continue with the chapter. So students, up till now we have seen that Halku has given the money, 3 rupees, to landlord as a rent. Okay, now the first part of the story is completed here. So now we will see further. The scene is now in the field where he has gone to guard. So because as the topic says, the story is all about January night, how a farmer spent his night in the month of January guarding the field. So now let us see what happened further. A dark January night, in the sky even the star seemed to be shivering. So here dark, the January night was very dark. Why dark? See, because even the moon was not maybe full, it was not a full moon light. And during the winter season we have seen the night is very much dark, the stars are also not clearly visible, so it is more dark. So here one sentence is written that the star seemed to be shivering. Can a star shiver? Never. Here it is personification. Personification means when we are identifying or comparing any non-things, non-living things with a person. So here what is meant by shivering? Shivering means shaking out of cold. So during the winter season we all shiver. So here the cold was so terrible that even the star seemed to be shivering. A star cannot shiver ever. But here, just to show how cold the night was, this comparison has been done. At the edge of his field, underneath a shelter of cane leaves, Halku lay on a bamboo cot, wrapped up his old shawl, shivering. So here, where was Halku? At the side of a field, there was a, under a cane leaves. Cane leaves means cane plant leaves was there, or bamboo plant was there. And Halku was lying in his bamboo cot. Cot, what does it mean? You must have seen, that is called khatia. Okay, it is a wooden furniture which is having ropes, tied with ropes and all. And it is used for sleeping in the village especially. So Halku, he was lying on that cot and he was having just an old shawl, and just because he was not feeling comfortable and the winter was too extreme, he was also shivering. Underneath the cot, his friend Jabra the dog was whimpering with his muscles pressed in his belly. So underneath the cot of Halku there was his dog. What was the name? Jabra. And Jabra was also feeling very cold. And basically you must have seen that when the dogs are sleeping, or how they are curling themselves, they are bringing their nose very much close to their stomach. So he was making a low sound and he was also feeling very cold, Jabra. Halku curled up and said, "Cold, Jabra, didn't I tell you in the house you could lie in the paddy straw? So why did you come out here? Now you have to bear the cold." So here we can see a close relationship between a dog and his master. So the Halku is very much concerned about his dog, and he is asking dog that why you came in this cold night. I have asked you to stay at home. "You thought I was coming here to eat puris and sweets, and you came running on ahead of me." So here he is commenting or criticizing or making fun of his dog, that the dog might have thought that Halku is going to field to eat some sweets and puris. So that is why the dog also came along with him. He is simply passing a funny, this is a funny situation here, students. Now you can moan all you want. So now he is telling, moaning means what? When we had a loss, when we lost something, we moan that time. We feel sad. So now he is telling to dog that you came by thinking that I am going to have some sweet or puris here in the field. And that is why you came with me to the field. Now you just feel sad about this because now you are feeling cold. Jabra wagged his tail without getting up, protracted his whimpering and into a long yawn and was silent. So Jabra did not make any reaction, simply it was wagging. Wagging means shaking his tail. And then what happened? Whimpering means we have seen a low sound which is made by a dog. So his whimpering was made into a long yawn. Yawn we know, but when we do feel sleepy, so that time we yawn. So the dog also made a simple low sound and it was yawning and was silent. He did not bark or no reaction was there. Simply he continued his whimpering and it was yawning. Halku reached out his hand and patted Jabra's cold back. So now we see concern of a master here. So Halku just patted. Patted means softly when we are patting someone back. So that is patting. So with a concern, Halku patted Jabra's cold back. From tomorrow on, stop coming with me. A cold will get you. So here also Halku asked Jabra not to accompany Halku from the next day onwards. Otherwise, the cold will affect the dog. We will get through the night somehow. And he is consoling that this night will pass somehow. This is the reward you get for farming. While we do the hard work, somebody else gets the enjoy of it. So this is the bitter truth, what the story is all about. The landlord, they must be sleeping in their cozy bed with the blankets, with the cozy quilts and all. But here, the farmer who is doing the hard work, he is suffering a lot. So here we can see the pathetic, the pitiable condition of a farmer, that the farmer is doing all the hard work and the income goes to the landlord. So reward means what? Reward when do we get? When we do a good deed or something good, we get a reward for that. So always the hard work is rewarded. But here Halku is doing all the hard work, but still we can see how much painful his situation is. Jabra looked at him with his eyes overflowing with love. So here Jabra was continuously looking. Even you must have, those who are having pet at their home, they might have experienced these things, that the pet is having so much love towards their owner. So here also Jabra looked at him with his, in his eyes there was mere love for his master. Okay, so this paragraph basically shows the relation of a human with their animals or their pet. You have to come up with just one more cold night. Tomorrow I'll spread some straw. You won't feel the cold. So now again the master is asking, saying to Jabra that today somehow just bear the cold. Tomorrow I will lay some straw because straw is giving the warmth. So you will also feel the warmth. Jabra put his paws on his Halku knees and brought his muzzles close. Halku felt his warm breath. So now, so much attachment is there between the animals and the human here. So here the muzzles means nose. So Jabra brings his nose very much close to Halku and Halku could feel his warm breath. Halku lay down like some kind of witch. The cold weather continued to torment him. So now Halku was also lying down, but the cold weather, the weather was very extreme. The cold was very extreme. Okay, so it was giving the pain like a witch, which we have already seen in Adventures of Isabel. So here also the weather was behaving or giving pain like a witch. When he could no longer bear it, he gently picked Jabra up and got him to fall asleep in his lap. So now when the cold was very much, he was not able to bear the cold, what did he do? When Halku could not bear the cold, he brought Jabra and he held him in his lap. The dog's body gave off some kind of stink, but Halku, hugging him tight, experienced a happiness he hadn't felt for a month. So here also, students, we can see that Halku held the dog in his lap and he was having a very close attachment, bonding with the dog. The body of the dog was giving some kind of bad smell, but the smell did not, Halku did not mind the smell at all. Okay, and he was feeling very happy, very comfortable, very satisfied. When we meet someone of our own and we hug them, so definitely we feel so much satisfied. We are overfilled with love. So same situation we can see here. Jabra probably thought he was in heaven, and in Halku's innocent heart there was no resentment of his smell. And Jabra, because when a master loved his pet so much, definitely an animal was also feeling that he was in heaven. And in Halku was also, he was also very satisfied. The smell of the dog did not matter at all to Halku. He embraced him with the very same affection he would have felt for a brother. Just imagine the close bonding people. The dog. Here the dog is compared, the affection towards the dog is compared towards affection towards the brother. So same feeling what Halku may be having for his brother, he was having when he was hugging or holding the dog. He was not crippled by poverty yet. So crippled here means having no strength, okay, or handicap. So he was very poor, okay. Monetary, financially, Halku was very poor, but he was having a dog whom he loved very much. So though he was very poor financially, still in the matter of relation, he was lucky because he was having a faithful dog with him. Rather, it was though the singular friendship has opened all the door to his heart and brilliantly illuminated every atom of it. So here, holding Jabra in his lap, Halku was feeling as if he is having, holding his brother. He was having the same feeling. And then again, he was feeling that the singular friendship. What was the friendship? Which friendship? The friendship between Halku and Jabra had opened all the doors to his heart. All the doors means, open the door of the heart means to welcome wholeheartedly. When we open the door towards the heart, that means we accept that person wholeheartedly. So though here the friendship is about an animal and a human being, still the bonding is same what affection we have towards a human. So here the friendship is very strong between the two. So today we will stop up till here. Tomorrow further we will continue. So hope everyone will be continuing the reading, students, and be safe and secure. Good night. God bless you.